my next video, I'd like to do one on the app Samsung Pass and or Samsung Wallet. They're both the same app, and I wanted to clear up some confusion that even I've had with these two separate apps that are now one, and they've been one for a long time, I know, but I always thought they were two separate ones. They kind of are, but you can get to them from just going to the one, the Samsung Wallet. And what the pass is to the app, the Samsung Pass, is a password manager, and it's a pretty darn good one. I'm going to start using it, maybe make another video on just that by itself on how to use it. But if you're like me, you're always not remembering your passwords, going to websites, can't remember your password. And then once you do, they make you change it every so often. And it's just, passwords are a big hassle. I don't understand why our phones have eye recognition, they have fingerprint recognition. Why the websites have got to be so difficult for passwords? It's like you have a credit card and they make it harder it is to pay for your bill. I mean, who's going to hack your account and pay your bill? It just, none of that makes sense. So anyway, off topic. So I want to go over the Samsung Pass app and go over a few things with you. First off, obviously, I'm using a Samsung S25 Ultra. This works on any Samsung device. There are other password managers out there, but I always like to use, when possible, the phone's company, like Samsung. I try to keep all my apps that I have options to use as Samsung. So like Samsung Note, Samsung Browser, I use that, etc. So let's dig right in, as I would say. So let's go. I have it set under business, and right here at the very bottom is the app, and it's called Samsung Pass, but when you open it, it's Samsung Wallet. So as you can see, the name is Samsung Wallet. And then in Wallet, we can just briefly go over that. You have all these different sub-apps, if you will. So like transit card, memberships, gifts cards, coupons, digital keys, digital IDs, health passes, boarding passes, they're all here. But then you have, at the top, payment cards and Samsung Pass. And here's where the confusion can start, but I wanted to clear it up. So Samsung Pass, go ahead and open that. And in that, we have, and some things I don't want to type on because I don't want my personal credit cards and everything getting out here, but payment cards, you type that. That's a list of all your payment cards, your credit cards. And then you have the tab Samsung Pass, which has sign-in information. And then you also have private info, which is cards, addresses, etc. So you can hit the plus and verify with key, with fingerprint. You can add sign-in info, cards, addresses, notes. So again, this is a very powerful app that's if you want, you could call it a suite of apps is what it really is. It's not just the wallet anymore. It's Samsung Wallet / Pass / gift cards / all these. So you get the idea of here what I'm saying. So quick access, and yep, there's my credit card, which you can't really see it anyway, but you can get set this up so you can make a payment real quick and whatever. That's off topic. So Samsung Pass, we'll go into that. And then we have our different sign-in info. And these are all, I'm not going to tap on one because I don't want to be giving out my information. But these are all the different kinds of websites. And your username. And then, of course, if you tap on one of them, it'll go into it and it'll set your password. So like say we want to set a new one. So this is what all the information you'd get. You'd get set in location. So you put the web address, you get that. Then you have your user ID, of course your password, and a note if you want. And then whenever you go to that website, it's going to kick this in, and hopefully, not always, it's had some bugs in it every once in a while, will open up that particular username and password and allow you to enter into the website. So it's very handy for your passwords. I'm going to start using it more often. I'm the old school where I use my notes app and I have them all in there, and it's just, it's overwhelming now. I have to set it up a different way because it's just, it's too much. It's just too much there. And I always love the saying, work smart, not hard. And if you have the way to get and use a device or a tool like Samsung Pass, you might as well do it and take advantage of it, so it makes your life easier. So I hope you found my video to be helpful. Thank you for being here. Please click like and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment down below. Thank you for your time. And until next time, I'm out.